Hi everybody, my name is Alex Gonzalez and I play the violin with a group called the Sphinx Virtuosi. I'm so happy to be here with you all to chat a little bit virtually and to share a little bit of music with you as well. Now you may be wondering, who are the Sphinx Virtuosi? Well, the Sphinx Virtuosi is a very special collection of really great people. The Sphinx Virtuosi is one of only a few orchestras nationwide that is made up entirely of Black and Latinx string soloists. When we tour the country, we choose to program music by people from underrepresented ethnic and cultural backgrounds with a hope that we can build bridges and show that we are all more alike than we are different. So, now that you know a little bit about us, how about we get to know the orchestra? The Sphinx Virtuosi is a string chamber orchestra, which means we are an orchestra made up entirely of instruments from the string family. So, let's get to know the instruments. So the first instrument that we have is the violin. The violin is the smallest of the string instruments, which means it can also play the highest. While the violin is known for playing very high and very fast, it can also play very gently and sing very, very sweetly. So, let's take a listen. The second instrument that we have in the orchestra is called the viola. Now the viola looks a lot like this violin that I have right here, but the viola is actually slightly bigger than the violin. So the viola might be about this much bigger than the violin. The viola has its own very special set of characteristics. It can play slightly lower than the violin can because of the size, and it also is known for its very rich and very deep tone. Now let's see if you guys can hear the difference. The third instrument that we have in the orchestra is called the cello. Now the cello is much bigger than the violin or the viola, so much bigger that they can't play their instrument like this, like we can, under our chins. They have to sit down to play the instrument because it's so big. Because the cello is much bigger, that means it can play notes much lower than the violin and the viola. And the cello can sing very beautifully on the upper part of its register, and on the lowest part of its register, it can play a really low, growling, rumbling sound. So, how about we take a listen to what the cello can do?
Mm-hmm.
Last but not least, we have the double bass. The double bass is the biggest instrument in the strings family, coming in at maybe 3 times taller than some of you are right now. Now, the double bass has to be played standing up because it's so big. And because it's such a big instrument, it can play the lowest, deepest notes of any string instrument. So, let's see how low the double bass can go. So now that you've gotten to know all of the instruments on their own, let's see what happens when we put them all together. The piece that you're about to hear is called Delights and Dances, and it's by an American composer named Michael Abels. In this piece, you might be able to hear elements of country fiddling, country dancing, or jazz music, as Abels tried to tie in a lot of different styles of American music in this piece. In this piece, you'll hear the orchestra come together, but you'll also be able to hear 4 solo string instruments playing in the front of the orchestra. Now, while you listen, try to pay attention to the different ways that the instruments are interacting with each other, and try to identify at least 2 to 3 different ways that you notice the instruments communicating with each other.
Thank you.
The second piece that we want to share with you today is an excerpt from a piece called The American Quartet, and it's written by a Czech composer by the name of Antonín Dvořák. Much like the Abels that you just listened to, Dvořák also loved all of the American folk traditions that we have in this country, and he tried to put them all into this quartet. Whenever I hear this piece, I can't help but envision cowboys and cowgirls riding on horseback around the Old West. While you listen, I want for you to think of at least 2 to 3 descriptive words or emotions that come to mind when you hear this music. After the piece ends, I want you to take a moment to share what you think with your class or with your teacher.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for joining us for this concert today. I hope that you had as much fun as I did, and we cannot wait to play for you again in person. To close out, here is a performance of a piece that you may have heard before. Please enjoy our arrangement of America from the musical West Side Story by the American composer Leonard Bernstein. Thank you.